Hello, my name is Josephine Lang, and I'd like to talk to you today about the women's spirituality movement. This is something that has brought me so much joy in my life because it has really helped me to reclaim the feminine divinity within myself and also within my friends. And so groups of women get together, perhaps on the new moon or the full moon or once a month. Sometimes it's arranged that way, or sometimes with the wheel of the year. And we gather and empower each other by listening to each other's hearts and desires and what is of significance. Sometimes with the moon cycle, we might meet at the new moon with the idea that what we are trying to accomplish, our goals in our life, are fulfilled by the full moon. Or we might meet at the first menses of a young girl at the menarche, or have a celebration at menopause as a woman becomes a crone and enters into her wisdom years. The wheel of the year is often a basis for these women's spirituality circles, and that's just looking at the year in terms of how people have always looked at the year through all time, which is to notice the solstices, one in the summer and one in the winter, and the equinoxes, one in the spring and one in the fall. And at the equinoxes, our day length is of equal length. And then at the solstices, of course, we have our shortest day and our longest night at winter solstice and our longest day and our shortest night at summer solstice. And then in between each of those four markers, if you were to look at the year as having four spokes, the two solstices and the two equinoxes, in between each of those is what they call the cross-quarter holidays. And there are four of those. So in between the winter solstice and the spring equinox, there is Candlemas, which is sort of the beginning of the year. Oh, well, some people feel that the beginning is at winter, and some also feel it's at the fall, but however you want to look at it is all fine. It all works. That's one of the beauties of the women's spirituality movement, is there are no rules. Anything goes. And so that's a really great part. And then after the spring equinox and before the summer solstice, there is Beltane, which is right around May 1st. And then after the summer solstice and before the fall equinox, there's Lammas, or the first harvest ceremony. And then after the fall equinox and before the winter solstice, there's Halloween or Samhain. And so one of my women's spirituality groups meets at all of those holidays, the four equinoxes, the two equinoxes and two solstices, and the four cross-quarter holidays. And then we celebrate those in whatever way we feel inclined. We might have a purification at the beginning of our time together, where we might sprinkle a little water from a sacred spring or a beautiful place that we found out in nature over each other to purify. Or we might use sage, burning of sourgrass or white sage here in my community area in San Luis Obispo. Or we might go ahead and just purify with a few grains of cornmeal, perhaps. And then after the purification, we go into a little bit of a ceremonial time where we do something which could be celebrating whichever holiday in whatever way we might find significant. We might play with a pile of fallen leaves in fall, or we might plant seeds in spring, or we might create women out of bread dough and bake bread at Lammas. So any number of things. And then we will sing too to raise the cone of energy. And afterwards we might have a potluck lunch and celebrate. And a women's circle is very easy to form. All you need to do is just put a notice up on a bulletin board or ask a few friends to join and then ask them to ask a few friends. And before you know it, you've got a beautiful circle ready to go. And a lovely way to grow our own individual divinity. Thanks so much for listening, and I hope you check out my website and my radio show, which is there every week. It's a weekly show called Step Into Magic. Thank you very much for listening. Bye now.